Are y'all running for anything? From anything?
I'd like so bad to be able to tell these guys without hurting their feelings, hey man, seen the 70s and we can't continue existing in the last century. We've got to move forward. You know? Hey, the best thing about capitalizing on a good investment is just like surfing, catching the wave is knowing when to get off of it. And the time to get off of this is now. The time for them to do what they want to do is only gonna exacerbate, you know, all the turmoil and everything between the county and the city. Especially if people come to realize that we had a chance to take it back, or at least, you know, garner our own share. I mean, I can see that really creating some uproar, you know? That would make me mad to know that the county had an opportunity to step forward. You know, it wasn't the right thing to do back in the 1970s. You know, the county was really rural, and they wanted to remain so. And they felt that if they didn't get water, then, you know, things would stay an acre, or the densest it would grow would be an acre or 2 acres, you know, and they'd maintain their rural charm and character. Nice try.
How's it going?
Good.
Are y'all here? Are you here to speak tonight?
I don't know if they're in the bill. Last time I didn't speak.
I didn't know if we had to sign in. I don't know if the county made you have to sign in, but I didn't see the sign in form.
No, I don't know. It says new business.
On this muni code for the city of Cumming, It states that if you want to address the city council and the mayor, you have to notify the clerk before 12 noon of the day of the meeting.
Oh, really?
So.
Unless they have some kind of special. Why did they invite people to the night? Because it was a.
Because on the website, they posted it under public hearing category as well as under their special called meeting category.
Uh-huh.
So the same meeting was published under two different web pages. And because it was under the public hearings category, it was a total mistake.
Oh.
And Brant Meadows came about 30 minutes before the meeting and he said, I'm ready for the public hearing. And he had a printout of the web page where it was advertised under public hearing.
Uh-huh.
And I want to address the board. And so Dana Miles said, well, let me look into it. And sure enough, they held the public hearing because that's how they advertised it.
What would be the benefit of annexing to the city versus?
Cheaper water.
Well, there you
go. I know it always comes down to money, doesn't it?
Of course.
That's the reason most people make decisions.
Cheaper water.
But
I guess if they use a lot of water, that is a consideration.
Yeah. Since it's being annexed into the city, they have different zoning regulations than the county does.
Right.
And we're not in the city. We're right across the street. Santa's Road is the dividing line. So we actually have no leverage at all. But once it becomes city property, county property, we do have a lot of leverage because we're county residents.
Leverage.
We just, well, because we're voters, you know,
right.
And taxpayers.
Right.
So.
Well, you would imagine that the city of Cumming would care what the citizens of Forsyth County are, though.
That's why I'm here.
Being that close of a neighbor.
That's why I'm here, exactly.
What do you know about the county or the city standards? Congruent or they're that?
They're similar. They're very similar, it seems. But they're not as clear cut as the county definitions.
Yeah. Forsyth County is an exceptional county. so we do that. Businesses come here and thrive.
Yeah. Well, we want to keep it that way.
Yeah, we do.
You know?
A 5-bedroom, 4-bath house, I sold it. Divided by 5, and that's how much my house is. It's like, you know, so, which.
Well, you know, all these regulations, that have been put on the lenders now, one of those is the mortgage process, and now they have to go through that third-party process.
Well, there's so much abuse, you know.
Well, yeah, I mean, they went from this extreme to this extreme. They need
you remember state income.
Oh, yeah. Or no.
Or chief of speculative development. That is exactly what it was. They had people borrowing money on their home, borrowing 120% cash loan to value on their paid off homesteads and turning into construction conglomerates and buying
property on spec, okay, and then borrowing against it at 120% LTV, okay, and next thing you know, we've got pipe farms everywhere. And that was exactly what happened. That's what tanked the banks.
We were working with buyers, and we were like, I appreciate the fact that they can buy property because I make money, but
yeah.
I was like, how are they doing this? How are the mortgage companies allowing this to happen? Well, really?
No, unfortunately. There's a time, it's one thing to ride the wave, it's another thing to want to jump off the board.
Yeah. Timing is everything.
It is. Getting into the market's one thing, knowing when to get out is it.
Yeah. It's easy to get in.
Yeah.
Like right now, I tell people, if you're going to sell a house now, you're not going to make what you probably would want to make, but if you're buying, you'll probably make up the difference on the buying side in most cases.
Yeah, you're buying something more.
Your camera makes mine look puny.
How are you doing?
Doing really well, thank you.
So yeah, they've got a whole space set up on either side now, huh?
Yeah, so with the safety tape on the carpet.
Well, maybe then, it looks like, you mind talking to us before they get started here? Okay, we'll go ahead and do that out in the hallway.
Getting these.
Hello. Did I break the plane today?
How are you doing?
Hey,
it's good to see you again.
You doing all right? It's my son, Judson.
Hey, Judson. Nice to see you.
Hey, good to see you. Welcome.
Hey, Judson. Can I use my camera?
Mom?
Would you hold my camera and film?
Yeah, sure.
All right, you hold it any way that's comfortable. This is wide angle, W. This is telephoto. And that's on and off. So just keep it rolling the whole time.
Okay.
You got it?
And film steady.
Well, I'll be back, but I'm just going to be talking to them.
Okay. We're alive. You're doing a great job there, sir.
Does that thing a steady cam?
I don't know. It looks pretty steady.
He just got the job.
Noon prior to.
That's a good question. How y'all doing?
Good. How about you?
Doing very well.
Thank you.
I have 7:30 scheduled time for May 15th regular city council meeting. I want to welcome everyone. Thank you for being with us tonight. At this time, I'd like to, for everyone to put their cell phones on silent, if they would, or vibrate, please. And stand for them, if you would, and pledge a flag with them, please.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much. Okay, before we adopt the agenda, I have a request that we have a couple of add-ons that were in by noon today, requested to speak tonight. Consideration of the agenda, we have Mr. Brant Meadows and Mr. Hal Schneider. With the council's permission, I'd like to have that added on as a number four item under new business, or item one under new business. I'd like to have a motion. Second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, the first item on the agenda is consideration for
for adoption, the last regular council meeting, and also the executive session minutes of May 17th and May 7th. I assume everyone got a copy of those minutes. If no corrections, the city will entertain a motion. Have a motion and a second? Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, item two, proclamation resolutions, recognitions. Again, thank all of you for being with us. Recognize Commissioner Bale, Commissioner Amos, Commissioner Roth. Thank all of you for being with us. And all of the dignitaries that are here tonight, we appreciate you coming to see us. Would you come in for us? Okay, under old business, there are here none. Under new business, the add-on, the items as we receive them, Mr. Brant Meadows, we have the first speaker tonight. By the way, how much time do we going to need?
I need about an hour and a half. I'm just joking, Mayor. I only need about 2 minutes.
Okay, 2 minutes. Mr. Schneider?
2 minutes.
Okay. All right, thank you.
Mayor, City Council, thanks for allowing us to speak here. We take some very important actions potentially this evening. I brought to you at the last meeting some concerns about the legitimacy of this body, specifically under Georgia Code 21-2-291, and specifically spells out under statutory and legislative action for provisions for you to follow if you're unopposed. I believe that that law, particular law 21-2-291, was not followed. In that law, it says that if there is an issue submitted before the electorate, which there was, that being SPLOST, that each of you gentlemen should have been on the ballot and you should have had votes cast for you. There were no votes cast for you. So I bring to you a concern about the legitimacy of this body before you take on important actions. If you would, please consider going before the Attorney General, the Secretary of State, and asking for them to have a clarification of that. Also, I would ask that all of you gentlemen, please be prepared for the loss negotiations. And also, there's training available for the loss negotiations provided by the state of Georgia. So when we get to the point of local option sales tax splits, I hope that each of you will know exactly what the law is relative to local option sales tax splits and negotiations between the city and the county. I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Mr. Schneider.
Good evening. My name is Hal Schneider. I'm a resident of Forsyth County. Thank you for allowing me to speak. I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about the water contract negotiations, and to ask that all of you take the time to review the lawsuit between the city of Falls Church, Virginia, and the county of Fairfax, Virginia. In that lawsuit, it was ruled that the city of Fairfax, or the city of Falls Church, could not charge the county any more than the actual cost for water that the city provided to the county. I know that the proposal that the city has submitted to the county is raising the raw water rate from 10 cents per gallon to 50 cents per gallon for some period of time, and then it raises to 75 cents per gallon. That's a 7.5 times increase over what the city charges today. And it would behoove this body, as well as the city attorney, to review the lawsuit that I mentioned earlier, because based on that precedent, the city would be breaking the law in that they would be taxing the county residents without representation. That's what the ruling of the judge and the court in Virginia was. So I would urge you all to take a look at that lawsuit. Thank you very much.
Question, Mr. Schneider.
Yes.
First of all, we are a city that provides water not only for the city of Cumming, but we have about two-thirds of the city customers is outside the corporate limits of the city. My question is, do you think our water is worth as much as the surrounding cities and counties' water.
I think your water is worth what the county of Forsyth is able to produce treated water at, and that's 52 cents per thousand gallons. So to answer your question though, the cost of the raw water is only worth what it costs you to pump it out of the lake and deliver it to the Forsyth County treatment plant. Whatever that cost is for you to pump the water from point A to point B, that's your cost. And according to this lawsuit, that's the only thing you're allowed to recover is your cost for doing that.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, item A, planning and zoning. We have annexation request 032012, Medicus Property LLC. And I think that requires a public hearing. Mr. Scott Morgan, Director of Planning and
Development. Yes, sir, Mayor. If I could be, before you open the public hearing, if I could address your attention to the staff report in the packet and the planning board recommendations. The property owner has made application to annex 1.144 acres. It's located at 990 Sanders Road, south of the intersection with Buford Dam, into the city limits, and the property is contiguous to the city boundary and therefore in compliance with the state annexation law. And Forsyth County, as of yet, has not responded, stating they have no objection to the proposed annexation. The property is currently zoned county agricultural and has an existing residential structure, and they are seeking city office professional zoning. The adjacent city property is also zoned office professional and contains existing office buildings. And the county property across Sanders Road is currently zoned a combination of business park and single family residential. The requested office professional zoning is in concert with the surrounding districts and is in conformance with the city's future land use plan. And to the best of our knowledge, the surrounding property owners have no objection to the proposed annexation and rezoning, and such action would not be detrimental to the property values, use, or enjoyment. The planning board did hold a public hearing on April 17th, and with no recorded public comments, they voted unanimously to forward you the request to the council with a recommendation of approval with the following conditions. Number one, the final approval of the annexation and rezoning by the City Council would not occur until Forsyth County has responded in writing that they have no objection to the proposed annexation. And as I said, we do not have that in writing yet. The existing residential structure, this is condition number two, will be demolished prior to development of the proposed office building. Condition number three, the proposed office building will match the look and type of the adjacent existing office buildings, i.e. brick and mortar construction materials. And condition number four, the proposed office building will be permitted 29 surface parking spaces above the maximum allowed according to the zoning ordinance for a total not to exceed 69 parking spaces. I'd be happy to answer any questions before you open for a public hearing.
I understand you to say that you don't have all the documentation in file for proceeding with this project other than the public hearing.
That's correct. We do not have the final documentation from the county state and have no objection.
Okay, but we can go ahead with the public hearing, right, Council?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Sure. Got it. Okay, anyone here? Would I hear a motion to open for public hearing?
Make a motion.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. United. Okay, public hearing for zoning annexation request 032012. Medicus Property LLC. Do we have anyone like to speak in favor of that application?
Mr. Mayor, members of the council, Ethan Underwood with the Lipscomb Johnson firm. We're representing Medicus Properties. This is an addition to a successful office development that's been created on Sanders Road. It's the Cumming Professional Plaza. There are currently dental and medical offices that are doing quite well and have developed an attractive building and just created what was sought was office uses on this corridor. It's a good buffer between the heavy commercial and the residential across the street in the county. What we are proposing is just an expansion of that. We're asking to add a state of a little over an acre. We are comfortable with conditions that say that the architectural renderings have to match what's already been built. There will not be a new access. We're going to be utilizing the same access through the development. So they'll be using the same one off of Sanders Road. No additional detention structures. The existing detention structure in the development is adequate to serve this. And the variance that we're requesting is to accommodate vehicles. Our client has just experienced, they've got medical offices in Alpharetta, and obviously this one here coming, they've experienced that there's more cars than what the city code allows in the maximum, and try to avoid folks from parking on curbs or worse yet, across the street and on other people's property. We're asking for a variance of 29 parking spaces. With that, I'm happy to answer any questions that you have.
The structures that are planned, and I think I looked at it, I'm going to be sure that it's going to be made built from brick, stone, and steel buildings.
Yes, Your Honor. In fact, we submitted elevation drawings with the application, and if the City Council wants to make that a condition of the zoning, we're comfortable with that.
Detention and all the water runoffs taken care of.
Yes, sir.
Any other questions from the council? Thank you very
Thank
much.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Anyone else like to speak in favor? Yes, sir. Come up and state your name, please, for the record.
Good evening. My name is Brad Carlton. I'm a resident of Grove Park subdivision. We're located directly across the street from the subject property. Grove Park's a neighborhood community built in the 1990s with about 149 homes. Over the years, we've successfully worked with the developers along Sanders Road, including the Primrose Daycare Center, the Prudential Real Estate Office, the Northeast Georgia Heart Center, the Discovery Point Day Center, and Dr. Holbrook's Medical Office Park, which is adjacent to this property. While we encourage growth and development along Sanders Road, we're hoping for smart growth that won't have a negative impact on our community, including but not limited to traffic safety, noise and lighting pollution, and any other that may necessarily negatively affect our property values and quality of life. Sanders Road is a two-lane road between 20 and Buford Dam and Mary Alice Park Road. It's curvy, and we have a lot of traffic to cut through. We have a lot of people that don't necessarily observe the 30 mile per hour speed limit. And as a result of that, our subdivision is in the sharpest curve on the street. We've had two cars that couldn't make that curve and then ended up in our children's playground. So we have a concern about that. As long as the developer conforms to what he's already built there, as far as the height of the buildings, that they don't add any additional in and out driveways, and everything else is maintained, we would encourage them to be good neighbors as they have been in the past.
So I can count you as far the project?
If it's maintains the same design.
Have you seen the plans?
I just saw the site plan. I have not seen the elevation plans.
Okay. With Mr. Underwood, I'm sure that he'll work with you on any concerns that you have in reference to the project.
Great.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your time.
Anyone else like to speak in favor of the project? Anyone like to speak in opposition to the project? If not, I hear a motion that the public hearing be closed. Second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. There is no vote on this due to the fact that all the information is not in the file. So I would recommend that this be postponed till the June meeting. Would that be okay?
Yes, sir.
I hear a motion to postpone this to the June meeting.
So motion
to have a second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Item two, variance request number 2012120, Larose Madden. And I think that called for a public hearing. Director of Planning Zoning, Scott Horn.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mayor. If you would also go for public hearing, I would like to present the Planning Board's recommendation and would address it in the staff packet. The owner has made application variance to the highway business dimensional requirements of the zoning ordinance on a legal non-conforming 0.36 acre tract containing a telecommunications tower. You may be familiar, this is the Sprint Tower up on the ridge. This tract was part of a larger 1.47-acre tract purchased by Forsyth County, less power site, and the county has waived its option to purchase the subject property. So the owner is asking this variance in order to make this a legal non-conforming lot. The highway business zoning will not change, and the tower will remain the principal use of the subject property. After that variance, in other words, from the dimensional requirements such as minimum lot size, setbacks, lot width, and those sorts of things. There is a recorded easement, permanent access easement, which will provide ingress and egress to this telecommunications tower. On April 17th, 2012, the planning board held a public hearing on this variance, and with no reported public comments, they voted unanimously for this request to the City Council with a recommendation. We have to answer any questions.
Council, any questions? Correct. Thank you. I hear a motion to open a public hearing on application 2012-125. Motion to have a second. Any discussion? Please vote. So if I can read your hand. Thank you very much. Okay, anyone like to speak in favor of the zone variance request 2012-120? Anybody like to speak in opposition? If not, I hear a motion to public hearing be closed. Second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. That doesn't need to be postponed.
No, sir. We would request a vote on this item.
Chair, entertain a motion.
Make a motion.
Have a motion to approve zoning variance request of 2012-120. Have a second.
Second, please.
Got a second. Any discussion? Please vote, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Item B, from the police department, Chief Taylor. Old Charlie Rester, ship. Got a change in manager of that, I understand.
Good evening, Mayor. Gentlemen of the council. Old Charlie's LLC has, or our local Old Charlie's Rester, number 264, has been bought out. They are under new ownership. However, the licensee, who's currently under the alcohol license, is going to remain the same, and it's Mindy Engel. They're going to continue to be the license holder for that establishment. We did do a secondary background check. You know, we just did one in January. We did another one, and I would recommend that you approve that. It's still good.
Conform to all regulations and stipulations, and there's no reason not to limit the ownership of the license.
Correct.
So basically, it's just the manager is leaving, or
it's the ownership. The LLC is actually changing ownership. The manager is still staying the same.
You're not having trouble out of it anyway.
No, sir. Okay.
All right. Any questions, Chief? Thank you, Chief. Okay. What's the pleasure of the board in reference to item Charlie's Rester ownership change?
I make a motion to approve.
Motion that request be approved. You have a second?
Second.
Any discussion? Signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay. Item C, consideration of ordinance to set a new meeting time for the City of Cumming to establish standard agenda. Councilor,
thank you, Mr. Mayor, members of the council. This is an ordinance to establish times, dates, places for regular meetings of the mayor and council, to establish a standard agenda, to repeal conflicting ordinances, to provide for an effective date, and for other purposes. The ordinance is several pages long. It's in your packet. Glad to answer any questions that you might have.
I think this is to bring up to date some of the old ordinances that we've had, right?
That's correct, Mr. Mayor. Okay.
Council has a copy. Is there any questions? Council have any questions? Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
What's the pleasure of the board? The zoning ordinance change. No. Is there entertain a motion?
Yeah, I'm
ready. Have a second. In discussion. Please vote. Signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, item D is the exterior of City Hall cleaning. We have noticed in the last several months, I don't know where some of the birds or something that have desecrated on some of the white trim around City Hall, the stone. And of course, October the 15th of this year, City Hall will be 10 years old, and we've never had the outside clean. So I think it's time that we do that, and we budgeted for this cleaning. And Steve, you have worked on the get some bids in for that, and I believe y'all came up with a recommendation that you want to give.
Yes, sir. We had three bids in the packet there. Two of them relatively close, and one of them was completely astronomical. We had bids of $9,000, $9,500, and then one for $24,800. And we checked into that, see what the difference was. It pretty much is in the name that the higher one was from a company, Restoration and Preservation Incorporated. As you mentioned, we just wanted somebody to clean it. So we checked out locals. Kind of step down a bit about the pressure washing and using safe material as far as plants and cleaning goes. We needed two more competitive bids, one, as I said, $9,000 and one $9,500. The $9,000 bid was from a company out of Douglasville, Georgia. The $9,500 bid was someone local. As a staff, we would like to recommend taking the second low bid is a $9,500 bid. Primarily, we've used this contract on other projects before and know it's worked and we feel more comfortable with it. That would be our recommendation.
I didn't see on these. I know they've all got insurance.
Yes,
Texas. That is fire cap insurance, okay. And the request is Wallace painting and trim is the a $9,500 bid, and that's a recommendation of the board because he's local and all the others are.
Yes,
the United Restoration is local, but it's $24,000. So, anyway, what's the pleasure of the board? Recommendation is Wallace Payne for $9,500 for exterior City Hall. Have a motion, have a second.
Second.
Any discussion? Please vote, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, item E, water proposal. Raw water was 30 cents a thousand gallon for a 15-year contract with an additional 15 years at 20 cents a thousand gallon. Now, if we're going to have quality water for our homes and businesses and coming in for South County, furnished by a state-of-the-art facility of the intake in Lake Lanier that was recently completed, and every step of the way the commissioners were involved in it, even members of the commissioners were carried over and given a tour of the facility. The additional water treatment facility, state-of-the-art, the city and county facilities wins state and national awards of the best water for this size of city and county in the state of Georgia. These facilities has got to be paid for. And it's my understanding, and looking at county's budget, that the water that the city sold the county last year at the current rate, the county profited $16 million. The city's budget is only $12 million. So the county made more money off of the water that the city sold them than their budget is. So who's making all the money? The county says that they want to have ownership of part of the intake facility. Well, to my knowledge, the federal government, the Corps of Engineers, has never deeded anybody in the property of Lake Lanier. You might get a permit, but you don't get deeds to it. And we've proposed more than fair proposal to the county commissioners May the 7th. I would recommend to the board that the proposal that was received May the 9th from the commissioners be rejected in its entirety, and the contract that expires, 25-year contract, May the 26th, it expires May the 26th, not be extended. I just think that we've been working on this, trying to get this proposal over to the county for the last 6 years. To extend this for another 25 days, I just think we're playing games. So the county has a proposal from the city of Cumming, which we sent over May the 7th. And it's binding. The county sends the city a contract, which is non-binding. So, till the commissioners get their act together, and the city can be represented, hey, we're part of Forsyth County. We have 10,000 customers outside the city of Cumming that we serve. I think rather than arguing about the price that the city's charging, the city and county both need to get together and have an understanding and have a price equal to each other throughout the whole county. And if y'all can't get your act together as commissioners, turn it over and put it on the ballot. Let the people, ask the people to vote on it. Do they want the city to furnish for South County or what? Take out the middleman, which for South County would be the middleman. Save that $16 million profit that the county made off of last year. So my recommendation is to reject that and in its entirety, and we'll go from there. The contract expires May the 26th. Your water's not going to be turned off. And by the way, when you go pay $2 for a bottle of water, $2.43 a thousand is pretty cheap. I think if you'll check, we'll come up with a rate structure, and we're going to work to collect the $11.4 million, because, like I said, somebody's got to pay for the infrastructure, and the infrastructure bill is sort of coming in from South County. The city of Cumming is holding a permit right now that gives it, the county 16 million gallon a day, and they're throwing this away. I let that contract expire from the Corps of Engineers in the state of Georgia. 16 million gallon on a monthly basis, 12 million gallon annual monthly basis. So my recommendation is for the county to get serious about it, pay the city what they owe us. We are subsidizing the county water and sewer for that matter, which is another issue. And have been subsidizing since September of 2010. A lot of money was spent to support county service here. And for the county to renege on not paying their bills is certainly deplorable in my thing. So, what's the pleasure of the board? Chair, entertain a motion.
Mayor, I make a motion that we reject their non-binding contract and also reject renewing or extending the present contract to June.
A motion for Brant to have a second.
Second.
Any discussion? Please signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay. Under announcements, we have Memorial Day ceremonies, which will be Friday, May the 26th at 11 o'clock at the Veterans War Memorial at the Cumming Police Department. Planned at the Cumming Playhouse is the Wizard of Oz, June the 7th through July the 1st. Any other business come for this floor? We'll be adjourned. Is there a motion to adjourn? Second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Thank all of you for being with us.
Hey, you're our sister.
last year on the water that came out of the city of Carlton. That needs to be addressed.
Have a good night.
Thank you.
That's a good one there. There was no election, not one single vote, not one vote.
You got my email address. Keep us in the loop with everything, okay?
Remember to look at the paper as you walk out of the room.
Okay, yeah.
Well, how are you?
I just interviewed about the water, too, so we'll be back maybe tomorrow to talk water.
Bring me back again.
Yeah, that's a very...
I have to cover these things. Yeah. Okay. These meetings. Thank you, Justin. Nydia.
Hey, Liz, I'm doing great.
Good.
Hello, Jack. I'm okay.
Hey, Jack.
Service demand, the justification of validating the veracity of the service demand.
then I just knew right from there. Sexton can't handle any more operations or anything additional. Just can't. That was it.
What do you charge?
Thank you so much.